So welcome to day 34. And today I pretty much just sat down and did some more work on this character portrait. And I really kind of focused on one primary thing, which I feel like I had some success with, but also I feel like there was some significant shortcomings with it as well. And that is the importance of shape. As you can see here, as I'm working, I'm literally just selecting big areas of shape and laying in some color over the top of it, and then blending it a little bit into the rest of the image. And I'm just trying to use this shape to emphasize the form, and not be quite so messy with paint strokes all over the place. I love a painterly and textured look, and I do think I lose some of that in this. That's something that I will have to work on in the future, trying to maintain is trying to keep some of that textured look a bit. The importance of shape can't be understated, I think. The whole thing reads so much more clearly as a result of this process. And this has kind of been the final stages of this experiment. So today will be the last day you'll probably see this one. And from here, I will be moving on to other projects. About time, all things considered, especially since this was originally supposed to be just a quick little experiment, and it has since gone on far longer than that. So, yeah, it really is about time that I move on to other things. But for the most part, I'm fairly pleased with this, and I feel like I've come out of this having learned two really important lessons, lessons that I really am looking forward to carrying over into my next project, whatever that may be. Lesson number one is the importance of texture and value. I've always struggled with working in color. That was part of the experiment here, was doing this purely in color from the get-go, not starting in grayscale at all. And it's always been something that I've really struggled with. And it took me years to learn that colors have their own kind of innate value. And you can't just throw down color and expect it to work, because you have to take into consideration how the color's value is affecting things, and you don't necessarily just see that without experience. So you always have to be checking that and double-checking and make sure that your values are still working solidly. And but even after I learned that, I still just always struggled with color. So when I started to learn the significance of laying down color, but desaturated color, building up the color harmony gradually and the values gradually, that started to make a lot of sense to me. And that was really the genesis of this experiment. If you go back to the beginning of this series of videos where these character portraits have been taking place, you'll see how chaotic I started with, and then gradually started to define that chaos into something more meaningful. Now, as I said, here at by the end, I feel like I lost a lot of that texture, which is something that I don't want to do. But getting those shapes right, I think, was really essential. And this was, I think, the other big lesson that I learned with regard to laying down that texture. Even very early on with this painting, I felt like I hadn't done enough with that initial laydown of texture and value and the very simple colors. I felt like I needed to push that even further. My darks needed to be darker, my lights needed to be lighter. And just in general, it needed to be so much more solidly fleshed out before I ever started filling in the detail and the big shapes, or the small shapes even. So when I take these lessons over to my next work, those are going to be a couple of things I'm going to really try and focus on. I'm going to try to make sure that in that initial pass of laying down texture and value and the basic colors, I'm going to do my best to make sure that those values are working the way they're supposed to, that they are as thoroughly blocked in as possible, so that everything I do on top of that is all about refining those form-defining shapes and getting rid of the line work, just emphasizing what the texture has already set up. That's the goal anyway, and the only way to actually do that is to do it and see what happens. Right now I'm actually working on the ear, which is, I think, the one thing that I am really not satisfied with this. In that ear is just a mess. And if there's one thing I would go back to and fix on this, it would be that. But I don't think I have the time to do that. So that's it for day 34, and I'll be moving on to other stuff from here on out. So thanks for watching, and there's more to come.